During the Buddha's time, there was a young Brahmin who often spent his time listening to the Buddha's Dhamma. He was virtuous, dedicated, and a good lay disciple. The Brahmin's wife was wicked and untrustworthy. She spent her days being lazy and not doing her duties. In addition, when her husband spent time at the temple, she would sneak various lovers in and sully her marriage. At least once a day, the wicked wife would feign illness, and her husband would ask, "My love, you seem so ill. What can I get for you?" "I need some sweets, fresh milk, and fancy rice." Her husband would bring these things to her, and she would say she felt better, but could not work. Instead, she would say, "My husband, I feel much better, but am too weak to do household chores. Please do them for me." After many long absences, the Brahmin went to make an offering to the Buddha and to ask him for advice. The Brahmin said, "My lord, my wife has problems with the wind flow in her body. She falls ill and cannot work. Even after I bring her the dainty foods and fine rice she asks for, she says she gets better, but still can't do any housework. It is because I've been looking after my wife that I have not been able to come study the Dhamma." The Buddha, through his supernormal abilities, already knew the truth of what was happening in the Brahmin's house. The Buddha then said, "Brahmin, in the past, you once asked me for medicine to treat your wife's stubborn ailment. I gave it to you, and she got better. And now, you've come to ask me again. It seems rebirth has caused you to forget." And after the Brahmin requested the Buddha to reveal the past, he told this story. A long time ago, when Brahmadatta was reigning in Benares, the Bodhisat was born as a Brahmin in a very distinguished family. After completing all his worldly studies, he decided to study the spiritual path and became very well known. Many young men from rich and high caste families came to learn from him. One of the great teacher's students was a wealthy Brahmin who had a very wicked wife. While he went to learn from the wise Brahmin, his wicked wife would invite other men into her bed. And when her husband came home, she would pretend to be sick and out of energy. Her husband worried about her and would often ask, "Are you okay, my love? What can I get you that would make you feel better?" The wife would ask for fresh milk, fine butter, and dainty foods. The husband would go off to gather these things. Even after eating these things, she would tell her husband that she felt better, but still did not have enough energy to do any housework. She would ask him to do it, and he would. And so, the Brahmin had to stop going every day to visit his teacher, and instead went once or twice a week. He explained the situation to his teacher, saying, "I'm sorry, teacher, that I have not been coming as often as before. My wife is sick, and the medicine she asks for does not cure her. I have to do her housework since she is not able to." Just by listening to the story, the wise teacher was able to see the lies that the young Brahmin could not. So he gave him this advice. "Ah, you've been giving her the wrong medicine. Obviously, the wrong medicine can't cure her of her disease. You have to treat the sickness with the right medicine. give her no more dainties, but instead collect different kinds of sour fruit and gather a few piles of cow dung. Then, mix them together in a new copper pot that has never been burned before, in order to get the smell of melted metal. Then, take a stick, rope, or cord with you when you go to give her medicine, and say the following lines. He then told the Brahmin what to say. So the Brahmin did as the wise master told him, and prepared the medicine. As the smell permeated through the house, the wicked wife came to find the source of the stench. When she saw it, she said,
"Where is that horrible smell coming from?"
"Your medicine, my love. You must be crazy. I would never eat that." "Well, the other medicine hasn't cured you. So my wise master prescribed this medicine. Once you take it, you'll be healed." The wicked wife responded, "I won't drink that, it's disgusting." "Well, my master said that if you don't, you will have to experience some physical encouragement. Either that, or you will have to do honest work for the food and lodgings that you use." At this, the wicked woman was terrified, and realized that the master had figured out her evil motives. So she humbly got up, and went about doing the housework. She felt guilty for what she had done, and vowed to live a good life from then on. And the Buddha concluded the Jataka story. He said, "The husband and wife of the past are the same husband and wife of this life. I was the wise Brahmin who gave the proper medicine." And the Brahmin went home and did as he did in the past. His wife realized that the Buddha knew the truth and was scared. She proceeded to do good and lived a proper life.
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.